Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to discuss how you can use k-means clustering algorithm for image segmentation. Okay, this particular algorithm is widely used in computer vision or digital image processing for this segmentation. So how it works? See, consider any image that may be grayscale or RGB color image. Okay, like here I have demonstrated this algorithm using RGB image. Okay, this is my color image. So red, green, blue. Okay, three values of pixels will be having for one pixel, right? Now you can represent each pixel in three dimension, where one dimension is blue, one is green, one is red, right? Now what k-means will do, it will cluster the nearest data set, like we have seen for mall customer segmentation, like that. Similarly, it will cluster the pixels, and for each cluster there will be one center point. It will replace all the pixel belonging to one particular cluster with the center pixel, okay, center of that particular cluster, and as a result segmentation will be done, right? So that's what we are going to implement in MATLAB. So before going to direct implementation, let me just give a recall on the reshaping of matrix in MATLAB, which I have already discussed in my previous video also, right? So this is required, guys, try to understand this properly. So suppose A is my this matrix. Now how A will look like this? Now you cannot apply k-means on this. For k-means like 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6, there is no meaning, right? For grayscale image, each will be having one pixel value between 0 to 255, and all those we have to make cluster. So basically, all these data points will be considered a single feature for k-means. Try to understand. So we need to convert this whole, all different values in a single data set, single column, we can say. And how you can do that? Simple, b equal to a of colon you can write, and you will be getting like this, right? I have discussed that this is the column representation. Now suppose if you require to go back from this to this representation, how you can do? You can simply apply reshape of b comma size of a comma 1, that is row, and then size of a comma 2, that is column. Okay, if you enter, see, we'll be getting back this. How it is working? Simple, I have told you. See, b is my this matrix. Now size of a is what? Size of a is basically 2 cross 3. So size of a comma 1 is basically 2. So after 2, 2 will be making one cut. So 1, 4, one cut, 2, 5, another cut, 3, 6, last cut. 1, 4, first cut values will be placed in the first column. Second cut values will be placed in the second column. Third cut value will be placed in third column. And see, we are getting back our original matrix only. So like that we can do, right? So keep this concept in mind, guys. We are going to use this. So CLC, clear all, close all, warning, N-I-N-G, warning off, okay? Run this part, clear everything, okay? Now what we are going to do? We are going to use one grayscale image first, then I will go to RGB. For grayscale implementation, I am going to take one image which is present in MATLAB database itself. So x equal to imread, okay, coins.png. Already used multiple times in my digital image processing playlist videos, right? I am show x. Let me just show you the image. See, this is the image. Now we want to segment this one, okay? So first b equal to x of colon, okay? All the values will be a single feature for my k-means clustering, right? For mall customer segmentation, just try to compare this to project, okay? For mall customer segmentation, what was happening? We had to basically cluster based on age and salary, okay? Now here there are two different features are present, but here only one feature. For grayscale, only one, okay? 0, 255, 239, like that, single values. And single values we want to cluster and replace all the same data point belonging to one cluster by the centroid, okay? Then apply k-means. Like, I hope you know what are the two output features, okay? M comma n equal to k-means b, and suppose I want to make 3 cluster, okay? Initially I am showing you 3 cluster. So M will be having the particular data point is belonging to which cluster, right? So if I just run this particular part of the code, my M will be what? My M will be like this one, or maybe belonging data point belonging to second, like 2, like these values. Now these values we cannot directly load on our this particular image, because this is 2D image, And if you check size of M, you will be getting 73,800 cross 1. That means one column matrix. Now this is nothing but column representation of the X, same size. Okay. Now we have to convert this to size of X. So how? I have shown you M equal to reshape of X comma size of X comma 1, that is number of rows present in X comma size of X comma 2. Okay. And this gives our required M, where for each M is now one matrix, 2D matrix, and here each basically our data is basically, okay, it will be, sorry, instead of reshape of X, it will be reshape of M, sorry. So here what will happen, each data, if you just take M, either 1 or 2 or 3. So here what is happening for X here, in this particular index you will be having some value, that particular pixel is belonging to which cluster it is giving us, it is belonging to third cluster, like that. Okay, now we want to put this particular label on our image. So for that, the inbuilt function is label overlay. It will label our pixels based on the second argument whatever we are passing, like label 1 one color, label 2 one color, label 3 one color, like that. Okay, label overlay, then I can give figure and IM show B. Okay, so this will give me my segmented image. Let us check. See, this is my output after applying image segmentation, right? So you can see clearly the segmentation happened. For this kind of data which are little bit brighter, we are getting this kind of color, which is in middle level we are getting this kind of bluish color, and for the background we are getting this kind of color. So perfect image segmentation is happening. Now you can play around this. I can change K value in each iteration, written the same code. Okay, you can check here, right? CLC clear all close all X equal to IMD, reading the image, showing in the subplot 1. Okay, original image, and for I equal to 1 to 10, I am varying my K value from 1 to 10. K means of X of colon comma I. Directly I am converting that our X, which is 2D matrix, to column matrix in this step. Previously, here we were doing here separately, here directly while applying k-means we are doing that. Okay, then reshaping that, and then our label overlay we are applying, and then subplot and title I am giving. Okay, so if I just run the whole code, you can see gradually values are changing, right? And this is for image segmentation for value 10 different labels we will be having. Okay,